Hey guys, so in this math lesson today, there's a few different things you're going to need before we get started. So first, I need you to look inside your green math folder, and you're going to see this real crazy looking paper that looks like this. It's got letters and dots all over it. So we're going to talk a little bit more about what that represents here in just a moment. So you're going to need that. You're going to need a pencil to write with, and then you also should have a protractor as well that is still in your green math folder from yesterday's lesson. All right, so you will remember from earlier this week, one day in the afternoon, we had a little bit of free time after your math test, and I pulled one of these out and we talked about it. We talked about how it's basically like a curved ruler, and we use this to actually measure angles. And then yesterday, you guys got a little bit of practice with this, but today, I think this lesson is pretty cool. So what we're actually going to be doing today is using our protractor, and we're going to measure the angles of the constellations in the sky. So if you don't know what a constellation is, what that is basically at night when you look up in the sky, you see stars, right? If it's not too cloudy, you should see several stars. So a constellation is what we name basically like a group of stars or like a pattern of stars. It's basically when you can see like a shape that the stars have created in the sky, and we give them names. And a lot of the names do come from Greek mythology. So like Hercules, that's the name of a star constellation, Perseus, Draco, and actually, if you turn the page here, you have all of the constellations that we're going to be measuring. So we're going to measure Draco, Orion, Hercules, Perseus, Canis Major, Cassiopeia, Cephus, Ursa Minor, and Pegasus. I know those are some real crazy sounding names, right? And some of these you may have heard before, like Hercules, Draco. I don't know if you're a Harry Potter fan, but that always makes me think of Harry Potter. But these are the names of some different constellations that we see in the sky. And what we want to try to do is measure the angles. So like for Draco, we have two angles. We have angle A, B, C. That's the name of the angle. And then we also have the angle E, F, G, and that's another angle. So we're going to try to measure both of these angles using our protractor and see what the degree of the angle measures to be. All right, so if we go ahead and close this, let's start right here at the very top with Draco. So this whole thing is Draco. See all these lines that are connecting these dots together? This whole thing right here that you see me tracing with my pen, that is the constellation called Draco. So we want to measure A, B, C, and then we'll do E, F, G. All right, so to measure A, B, C, it's not quite as easy as it was yesterday where you can just stick your protractor on there, line it up, and move on. This is actually going to be a little bit more tricky. So to measure angle ABC, we see A, B, and C right here. And what we're going to use is that middle point. We're going to say that that represents our vertex. So that's where we're going to put the rule or the protractor. We'll put that clear hole at the bottom of the protractor right on top of that vertex, and then we'll measure the angle that way. So actually, to measure this angle ABC, watch what I'm about to do here. Watch carefully. I'm going to have to actually turn my paper. I'm turning it clockwise, the same way that the hands on a clock move. And I'm doing that so I can better place my protractor on top of this angle A, B, C. So let's go ahead and do that now. So turn your paper clockwise. That way you can get a better look at the angle. And it does kind of look upside down, but that's what we're going to have to do here to measure the angle. So now if you pick up your protractor, that clear bottom hole at the bottom, you're going to place that directly on top of the vertex for the letter B. Okay. And I don't want it to, look like this. Remember, we talked about that yesterday. On a protractor, that bottom line that you see, that straight black line, that's called the 0 degree line. And that needs to be lined up with this line segment here from B to A. Okay, so we're going to line that up there. Now, I'm sure the thing that you should most notice here is that we want to measure the angle going all the way through B to C, but see how that's such a short line? So what we talked about yesterday is let's make that line longer. So we're going to take the straight edge of our protractor, and we're going to trace that line segment BC, and we're going to make it longer. See how I'm making that longer? That way I can see that blue line, or for you, your pencil line, going straight through my clear protractor, and it's going to make it easier for me to measure the angle. So now let's go ahead and line everything back up the way it was. Okay, so line everything back up. So the hole in the bottom of your protractor, you can see that point B right through it. Your 0 degree line is right on top of that line segment that connects B to A. And now you should be able to see that line going through your clear protractor. Now you'll see here that this appears to be an acute angle. An acute angle. So for that reason, we don't want to use the number on the top. That would be for an obtuse angle. See how those numbers get real big? We want to use the numbers on the bottom for an acute angle. And it looks like this angle measures to pretty much exactly 85 degrees. So it counts 70, then 75, 80, 85, 90. And it looks like our line here passes right through 85 degrees. So we would say the measure of that angle, A, B, and C, on the Draco constellation is, what did we say, 85 degrees? So we're going to write that here, 85 degrees. Okay, and if you guys, and same thing, you know, to the teachers that are helping them in the room, if we're off by 1, 2, or even 3 degrees, I'm not going to really stress about it that much. Like if yours was looking like 86 and I said it was 85, you're okay. Chances are you're still doing the right thing. But, you know, if I've got 85 here as my, you know, measurement, and you're getting like 120, then we might need to stop and pause the video and kind of review how we use a protractor from yesterday, right? Okay, so let's go ahead and measure the other angle now for Draco. So we're going to measure EFG. All right, so let's find, where is that out? Right here. So it's towards the bottom. We've got EFG. Now, the same thing that we did a minute ago, let's take that letter that was in the middle, EFG. F is in the middle, and let's say that that is our vertex. So if that's our vertex, watch what I'm going to do here. I'm actually going to take my paper, and this time I'm going to spin it in the opposite direction than I did the last time. I'm going to go counterclockwise until this F and G kind of looks like a nice straight line for me. That way I can stick my protractor on top of that. Okay, so go ahead and do that now. Turn your paper. All right, so again, we're going to say that F is our vertex. So using your protractor, you see that clear hole through the bottom. So we're going to place that clear hole right on top of point F. We're going to line up our 0 degree line on the line segment for F and G. And now again here, we'll probably have to do these for all of these. See that line right there between F and E? That's the line that I need for it to be long enough to pass all the way through my protractor. And as you can see, that's a very short line. So same thing we've been doing. Let's use the straight edge on our protractor and let's make the line longer. So that way it's going to be easier for us to measure the degree of this angle. So let's trace that just very easily with our pencil there. And see how we made that line nice and long? Now that's going to pass right through our protractor, and that's going to help us more easily measure this angle. Okay, so let's line everything back up just the way that we had it, and there we go. All right, so would you say that this is an acute angle or an obtuse angle? It appears to be an obtuse angle. So for that reason, we're going to use the numbers on the bottom here. See how the numbers on the top are close to 50? This is definitely less than a 90 degree angle. So we're going to use the numbers on the top here. All right. And it looks like if I start at 120 and count towards the 130, I know it's greater than 125. Looks like 125, 126, I would say 127. That's about what mine looks like. So if you're saying 127 or 128, you're on the right path there. So that's about 127 degrees. All right, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to flip this over. We're going to say that the degree of angle is, I think we said 127 degrees. Okay, and then I'm going to have you guys work with the teacher assistant in the room to go ahead and try to work your way through the rest of these. All right, so you'll move on to Orion. And Orion is right here beside it. So we're done with Draco. Now we're going to move on to Orion, use our protractor, and measure the angles it gives you. You'll start with BAN. And remember, you're going to need to extend the line. So for Orion, BAN, you're going to say that point A is your vertex. Turn your paper so you can better see the angle. use the straight edge on your protractor to stretch out a line, and then go from there. And then you guys will do the same thing with JLM, making that middle letter your vertex, L. So the clear hole that you see through on your protractor will just sit right on top of that middle letter. Okay. All right, guys, good luck. I hope you have fun with this. Don't freak out. Don't go into panic mode. If I said it was 127 and you got 128, you are fine. You are on the right pathway. So yeah, just have fun with it. You know, this is a pretty cool lesson that incorporates, you know, science and math and all those things that we love. So yeah, just have fun with this, and I'll see you guys this afternoon. Okay. All right, until later. Bye.